days ago and getting away with it. That's the thing he's trying to stay away from.
Yeah, that was not in a great location from a pitcher standpoint, but he got away with it. Here is Suzuki. What do you think will be his biggest adjustment regarding the transition from the Japanese big leagues to the American big leagues?
I think there's a lot of deliveries that are a lot alike over in Japan. Watching that team, I did the 06, 09, 13 World Baseball Classics, mm-hmm. and a lot of the guys have the same delivery. So there's going to be a lot of different deliveries over here. I mean, they talk about the velocity. It's 3-4 miles an hour on the average higher. I don't think he'll have a problem with that. I mean, you've just seen him in spring training get closer and closer to turn. Yesterday, he was turning everything around. I just, you know, he didn't have an outside at bat for 5 months till he got here.
Fastball up and in. 2-1.
All right, now. We play that game.
Inside again, 3-1. This is Saturday.
How a pitcher tries to back up, thinking that, like, he's got a string on that ball and he's going to pull it back in play. That ball was gone from the moment it came off that bat.
3-1. Let's see if he gets something to hammer inside. So he stayed in on the hands and ends up walking Suzuki, which, by the way, was a big part of his game. He's always had a good on base percentage because of drawing a lot of walks. It's always a plus. And here's Jason Hayward.
It was amazing for a guy like him to win a batting title. And what do you, 38, 39 home runs along with it? I just think he was he was more than Correa and more than some of the pitchers that were out there. I think he was the number
one. Here is Seiya Suzuki. Seiya takes outside. The Cubs have a triple, a homer, a single, in fact, two singles. And now a hit by pitch in the inning. Three runs in, still only one away, and men at first and second. These two teams will play in the regular season in the month of May. Two game series this year in each park. Play in Wrigley, May 3rd and 4th, Tuesday and Wednesday night games. Suzuki fouls it away in the two games on the south side at Guaranteed Rate Field. An odd series, a day off on Friday, and then a Saturday night, Sunday afternoon game. So a brief two-game series Saturday and Sunday with no game on Friday.
All six games last year were in August, were they not?
Sounds right.
White Sox going 5-1 in those games. I remember they won all three games at Wrigley.
Base hit for Suzuki up the middle, and this ball game is tied. Well, that ball got through the infield quickly.
what do they call that? Exit velo? There's been a lot of work in that department this spring with hitting coach Greg Brown talking about making better contact, and Suzuki brought that with him. This is how you win a batting title. This is how you hit a lot of home runs. Right back up the middle. He got knocked down a couple of times earlier. You know what? Let me knock you down. More than that. You know, we found out today that Justin Steele is going to pitch game two. And I'm sure that they're just trying to split up Kyle Hendricks and Marcus Stroman because their stuff's a lot alike. I don't know if it's been announced yet, but the way things look, you would think it'd be Mills and Drew Smiley, maybe piggybacking in game four.
You've got that off day, which means Kyle could come back and pitch the day after that. But then, I mean, what do you got, 11 straight games after that?
13.
You got 13 straight being on the road. I mean, you'd kind of like to have Simmons play one of those games and maybe maybe put Nico at second and give Madrigal a chance to DH or maybe Nico DHs. You'd like to have that flexibility, but right now you don't know.
Yeah, especially I think just given how much time Nico and Madrigal have missed due to injury, especially last year. So, you know, early in their young careers, they've had trouble staying on the field with some of the injuries they've had. So, yeah, obviously you want to protect him. And we just even saw that with Madrigal here a couple days ago where he felt just a little bit of soreness, you know, in his lower half, and the Cubs wanted to be conservative. They pulled him off. They scratched him from the game on Saturday. And, you know, he played in a sim game yesterday and obviously back out there today. But, yeah, definitely that conservative approach makes a lot of sense.
Suzuki with a count of 2-2. Cubs lead 7-5 here in the fifth inning. Suzuki has walked and singled to drive in a run.
I think the most impressive thing to me about Suzuki as far as his offense is concerned is he makes adjustments within the at bat. I mean, it's not just like he goes from one at bat to another, but he does it within the at bat from pitch to pitch.
Yeah, it was kind of cool yesterday in that sim game. I mean, it's just this empty Sloan Park, so it's a really cool visual. There's maybe like 30 people total between minor league prospects and front office and coaches. And so we were watching in the media, and Suzuki gets down 0-2 in a bat against Stroman, ends up working a 9-pitch at bat, and he struck out, but he was fouling off really close pitches, got to a full count, and Stroman afterwards was just talking about how you can't make a mistake around him. And
there's another base hit for Suzuki. Rick, let me ask you, from a pitcher standpoint, if you notice that a guy is making those adjustments pitch to pitch, what does that do to you?
Makes you mad. You know, and a big thing, and Tony, you talked about this in yesterday in that sim game, he was doing a lot of things up the middle. I mean, he hit the line drive off of Justin Steele. He hit a ball over the on one hop over
you
the.
You don't want to try to jar the ball loose from some big catcher. Not now. Come Thursday, maybe you do.
Come on, 67. This is my last chance to keep my home run streak going for Suzuki.
He's got a pair of singles and a walk. He has scored twice. Pitch by Sosa. Some guys, Rick, just seem to not mind falling behind in the count. I've only seen Suzuki for a handful of at bats, but it looks like he has that quality. If it's 0-1, 1-2, no big deal. I'm fine.
Right. Those adjustments that we talked about from pitch to pitch, and I mean, everybody he sees is for the first time. And we talked about different movements to fastballs and what's his secondary pitch. And, you know, that's where the preparation from, you know, our hitting coaches becomes so important to kind of give him an idea that if he falls behind in the count, this is what most of the time he does.
He tried to check, couldn't do it. The count 2-2. Both of his hits, sharp ground balls up the middle. I noticed that Harrison, now the second baseman, is almost directly behind the bag. Almost looked like Suzuki took a poke at right field with that swing.
Kind of a little bit fooled, wasn't he? It was an off-speed pitch, and he was out in front, everything but his hands. And he just kind of threw the barrel of the bat at it. You know, he just recently got his bats here. Remember that? We had pictures of that about a week ago. They came in. He's only got two of them here. And as of yesterday, he hadn't broke one, so he's still got two. But there's a whole box of them waiting on him in Chicago.
$8,000 are here today. $8,722. Beautiful day. Temperature right around 80 at game time. Breezy, cloudless blue skies. Just about ideal.
Attaboy!
You know, looking at that scoreboard, it's kind of ideal too. It didn't start out that way. I mean, you got a good look at what the White Sox offensively are capable of doing. That's where the big boys that put that four spot up. They're not around anymore. They too are getting ready for their opening day. Lucas Giolito, as with Kyle Hendricks, getting his third straight start. White Sox will open up at Detroit this year.
Breaking ball gets him looking. The Cubs score 7 and lead by 8 as we go to the 6th inning.